Friends, please like, share and subscribe this channel so that we can give you good quality videos in the future. Now, today I am going to complete this subject, strength of materials. I am taking the last unit, the sixth unit of your syllabus, which is torsion in shafts, torsion of shafts. You know what a shaft is. A shaft is a member of a machine which rotates. It is a rotating machine element. A shaft is defined as a rotating machine element which transmits power. Its work is it transmits power or motion. So it is circular. Generally it is circular, and generally it is made of mild steel. And these shafts come in standard diameters and standard length. The diameters of the shaft start from generally 25 mm, then they go on increasing 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, then 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 135, 150, 165, 180, 200 millimeter, etc., etc., etc. So these are generally the standard diameters in which they are manufactured. You don't get a size which is in between them. Generally we don't get sizes in between them in the market. Now why I am giving you this is, suppose you are asked to find out the dia of a shaft. In a problem, in a numerical, we are asked to find the dia of a shaft. And in our calculator, when we make a substitution, we get, let us say, 41.236845, something like that. We will get a number like this in our calculator, so many mm. Now we will have to adopt it. We will not get a shaft of this diameter. We will never get a shaft of this size in the market. So you cannot get it. So you will have to adopt it. Now what do you adopt? We have to adopt the size that is next to this, which is available in this this thing. So it has to be adopted as 45 millimeter. It is falling in between 40 and 45. In such case, what you have to do is you have to adopt a higher diameter this shaft for our purpose. So that's why I'm giving you this. This is to be noted. Whenever we get a value above, between two values, you will adopt the higher of the value after that. Next, the length of a shaft is generally limited to 6 meter. It will not be longer than 6 meter. In case we require more than 6 meters, then we will have to couple two shafts, two or more shafts, by using what we call shaft couplings. Anyway, which is not there for you. Now these shafts are subjected to torsion. When they are transmitting power, they are subjected to torsion or twisting. It is also called as twisting. In twisting, torsion is nothing but twisting. It is something like this. The force will be acting. When a shaft is transmitting power, it is circular, it is rotating and transmitting power, it will be subjected to a tangential force like this. This tangential force multiplied by the radius of the shaft F into R gives as what we call T, or which is called as torque or twisting moment. It can be called as either torque, or it is also called as twisting moment. Now, we have to find out how we have to this thing. Then shafts, we have two types of shafts. One is called the solid shaft. It may be either solid or a hollow shaft. Hollow, solid shaft means it will be full solid. Hollow shaft will be like this. There will be a hole inside here, and this will be like this. It's a hollow shaft. Now, this is called the dia of the shaft. Here it is called outer dia, and this is called as the inner dia. Inner dia, you use different symbols, DO, DI, or capital D, small d, anything can be used. A hollow shaft is better than a solid shaft. There are some advantages in using hollow shafts over solid shafts. These advantages you must know. That is, they are these hollow shafts, we are saving some material. The weight of the shaft is reduced, the material is reduced, and it will be in strength wise, though it is lesser in weight, strength wise it will be almost of same strength as this, because the stress distribution in a shaft, stress distribution will be like this. It is here, it is zero, it is called the neutral axis, it is zero here. And as we move from center to outer periphery, it goes on increasing and it becomes maximum at the periphery. This is how the stress distribution will be. So when we are making it hollow, we are removing the material where it is subjected to the minimum amount of stress. Thereby, there will be better stress distribution in the shaft. And as a result, it will be more reliable, more rigid than a hollow shaft will be more reliable and more rigid than the solid shaft. So these are some of the advantages. You are supposed to know this. They can ask you in the examination the difference between hollow shaft and solid shaft, or advantages of hollow shafts over solid shafts. That can be asked. Now, you will also get definitely a numerical problem on this. And these problems on shafts, torsion of shafts, are solved by using a general torsion equation, a equation which is known as the general torsion equation, which can be proved when we make some assumptions. General torsion equation, like the simple bending equation, general bending equation, we have an equation called general torsion equation. This equation is like this. It is T by J is equal to Fs by R is equal to C or G theta by L. This equation is called as the general torsion equation. In this equation, T represents maximum torque, or it is nothing but maximum twisting moment. We can call it as twisting moment also, on the shaft. On the shaft, in, it should be in Newton millimeter. Now, generally, this will not be directly given. This torque T will not be directly given. It will be given in a problem indirectly. Generally, what they do is they give the power to be transmitted. What is the power to be transmitted by the shaft, and what speed, at what speed it is to be transmitted. That is, P and N will be given. They don't give T, they give P, that is power in kilowatts, and they give N, the speed of the shaft, in RPM. If these two are given, we can convert, we can find out what is the torque to which it is subjected. Now, the torque that you get from these two is known as the mean torque. In case they have said in the problem the maximum, you design it for a maximum torque. They will say the maximum torque exceeds the mean torque by so many so much percentage. Then you will have to increase that and find out the maximum torque and use this. If they have not said anything, the mean torque itself will be the maximum torque. Now this J is called polar moment of inertia, polar moment of inertia of the section of shaft, of section of the shaft in mm to the power of 4, in mm to the power of 4. See, this moment of inertia means, you know, moment of inertia, we know, we have already studied. This is called XX axis, this is the center of gravity. We know how to find the moment of inertia on XX, and we also know how to find out moment of inertia on YY. Now this J will be mathematically IXX plus IYY. Now for a circular section, both will be same. IXX will be same as IYY. So it can be written as 2 times IXX, or it will be mathematically equal to pi d to the power of 4 by 32 in case of solid circular shaft, its value will be pi d to the power of 4 by 32 j in case of solid circular shaft. Here d stands for the dia of the shaft. D is the dia of the shaft. Then if it is a hollow shaft, it will be pi by 32 into DO, outer dia to the power of 4 minus inner dia to the power of 4, or you can use capital D to the power of 4 minus small d to the power of 4 also. This is in case of hollow circular shaft. It can also be written as, one more way of writing this is, pi by 32 into DO to the power of 4 into 1 minus k to the power of 4, where k is the ratio of inner to outer diameter. It is called the ratio of inner to outer diameter. Inner diameter, you know, will be always less than the outer diameter, so the value of k will be, this fraction will be always less than 1. So this is this, you can use either this formula or this formula, any one you can use, depending upon how it is given, how the problem is given. So we know how to find T and J. J is what is T and what is J. Sometimes they will ask you to write this equation and write what is what. If you write what is what, you will get 5 marks. Then then FS is permissible torsional shear stress, or simply you can call it as shear stress of shaft material in Newton per mm square. R is called distance of outermost fiber, that is the fiber at which the stress is maximum. The stress will be maximum at the outermost fiber. Distance of outermost fiber from neutral axis in mm. Neutral axis means the axis, that is the axis of the shaft. If it is a circular shaft, the axis of the shaft is called as the neutral axis. It is called as neutral axis because there will be no stress, or there will be zero stress there. Therefore, it is called as the neutral axis. So R means this distance from here to here. This distance is called R. If it is a solid circular shaft, R will be d by 2 in case of solid circular shaft. solid circular shaft, it is D by 2. It is DO by 2, that is outer dia by 2, in case of hollow circular shaft. Hollow circular shaft, R will be this. So this is, these are the two symbols used, and they stand for these things. Then after this, C is the modulus of rigidity. It can be either C or G. We can use either C or G here. So C or G is the modulus of rigidity or shear modulus. Modulus of rigidity of the material of the shaft in Newton per mm square. Theta is angle of twist permitted, angle of twist in radians. This will be generally given in degrees. In the problem, you have to convert it into radians. Angle of twist in radians, and L is length of shaft. Length of shaft in millimeter. So these are the units. These are the symbols. They stand for these things. Now, we can use either these two or these two or these two, depending upon how and what data is given in the problem and what is asked. Now, if they have asked only D, we have to find out only D. There are two types of design here. In two ways we can find the D, that is the diameter of the shaft, can be found out in two ways. One is using these two. Then we say that the diameter has been found on the basis of strength. If you are using only this much, then we say the diameter is found on the basis of strength of the shaft. If we can also get it by this, T by J is equal to C theta by L. From here also you can get diameter. If you find the diameter by this equation, you say the diameter has been found or the shaft has been designed on the basis of rigidity. On the basis of rigidity. This is on the basis of strength. This is on the basis of rigidity. Now, how we have to find the diameter depends upon the given data. Suppose they have given T and FS, nothing else is, these things are not given, then you will find D only by this and leave it. If they have given T, C, theta, L, and they asked you to find out D, then you substitute J in terms of D and you can get D. If you get that, then you have designed it on the basis of rigidity. We don't need to do it. Suppose they have given T, they have given FS, they have given C, theta as well as L. Then we have to do on both strength basis as well as the rigidity basis. And whichever case we get the higher value of the diameter, that should be taken as the diameter of the shaft. Now, we will take up some problems, a few problems from the question bank issued by the board, and we will try to solve some problems so that you will get to know how these problems are to be solved. We'll take up first problem number 5. A solid circular shaft is required to transmit 90 kilowatt. This is power. 90 kilowatt is to be transmitted at 180 rpm. This is the speed. 180 rpm is the speed. The permissible shear stress in the shaft, Fs, is 75 Newton per mm square. The maximum torque transmitted exceeds the mean by 20%. Maximum torque is 20% more than mean torque. Find suitable diameter of the shaft. So this is the given data and we are asked to find the diameter. This is problem number 5 given in your question bank, in the question bank issued by the board. Now, first what we have to do here is, first we have to find out the park. We know P and N, so we will get park. You know, the general equation for power is P is equal to 2 pi N T by 60. This is the equation to power. You all know this equation. You have used this equation a number of times. You know it. Now, in this relationship, it connects P, N and T. Three variables are there, P, N, T. Others are constants. So, if given any two of them, the third one can be found out. Here, P and N is given. So, I can get T. T is equal to 60P divided by 2 pi N. Right. Now, this is generally given in kilowatt and this is given in RPM. If you substitute these two as it is, as they have given it, you will get it in kilonewton meter. You will get it in kilonewton meter. Torque will be got in kilonewton meter. And then if you multiply it by 10 to the power of 6, it gets converted into newton millimeter. That is, kilonewton to newton, you have to multiply by 10 to the power of 3. Meter to millimeter, we have to multiply it by 10 to the power of 3. So, totally to convert kilonewton meter into newton millimeter, we will have to multiply it by 10 to the power of 6. Now, I will make a substitution here. 60 into P is 90 divided by 2 into pi into 180. This is what is given. So this will be 60 into 90 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 180 will give me 4.77 kilonewton meter. So this will be 4.77 into 10 to the power of 6. I told you why it is 10 to the power of 6. We have to convert this into kilonewton meter into newton millimeter. So 2 10 to the power of 3. So totally it becomes 10 to the power of 6. Now this is called the mean torque or the average torque which is coming on the shaft when it is transmitting this power at this RPM. Now, in the problem, he says maximum torque exceeds the mean torque by 20%. So, then what we have to do? What we have to do is, we have to increase this torque. See, this is the mean torque that is coming. Now, sometimes what may happen is, it may increase a little. So, if we design it for this torque only, then what happens is there is a chance when it increases beyond that value, it may fail or it may undergo permanent deformation. So, now for that not to happen, what we do is on the safer side, we increase it by 20%. Now, so T max, that is the maximum torque, will be equal to, if they say it is 20% more, it is T plus 20% of T, plus 20% of T. You have to give an additional 20% over the mean torque, or it can be taken as 1.20 into T. If it is 15% more, it will be 1.15 into T. If it is 30% more, it will be 1.3 into T. If it is 25% more, it will be 1.25 into T, like that. So here it is 1.2 into 4.77 into 10 to the power of 6. Keep this 10 to the power of 6 separate itself. So I have got 4.77 here into 1.2. If I multiply, I get 5.73 roughly. 5.73 into 10 to the power of 6 newton millimeter. So I have to find the dia of the shaft for this. for this. Now, first I have to, when these two are given, first I have to find out the torque. I have got the torque. Now, I have to design it. To design or to find the diameter, finding the diameter is now called as designing. Now, if I have to design it, I have to use this formula. P by J is equal to Fs by R is equal to C theta by L or G theta by L. Now, this, in this problem, we are not going to use this. Why? Because they have not given C, they have not given modulus of rigidity, they have not given the angle of twist, and they have not given the length. So, when these are not given, these three quantities are not given, we will not use this. We will only use this much, because the data is given like that. We will use only this much, and from here we will get the diameter of the shaft. Now, I know T, maximum torque, that is 5.73 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by J is pi d to the power of 4 by 32. This divided by 32 here, instead of writing here, I can write it there, is equal to Fs, it is given 75 Newton per mm square, divided by R. R is d by 2 because it is solid circular shaft. So 1d here, 1d here gets cancelled, you are left with d cube. We are left with d cube. So cross multiplying here, 75 into 2 into pi d cube, this multiplied by that is equal to 5.73 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32. So d cube will be equal to 5.73 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 divided by 75 into 2 into pi. Cube root of this will give you the diameter of the shaft required. So this into 10 to the power of 6, I have got that answer, 10 to the power of 6 into 32 divided by 75 divided by 2 divided by pi. I got this answer as something 389073, etc. So I want the cube root of that. D will be cube root of this. So cube root of that, from the calculator, cube root of answer is equal to, I am getting 73.0035 something. I'll get some 10 digit number, 73 mm. What I will do is adopt D as, you know, after crossing 70 mm, the next standard size available, standard diameter available is 80 mm. So I will adopt it as 80 mm, that is the diameter of the shaft. Now, if such a problem comes, it will fetch you 10 marks. This will be for 10 marks. Once again, I ask you, I request you to subscribe the channel. Thank you.